We want to solve the given quadratic equation using the quadratic formula. So the first thing we should recognize about this example is that the equation is not in the correct form in order to identify the values of a, b, and c. We need the equation to be in this form, where the form ax squared plus bx plus c equals 0. So for the first step, we want to set this equation equal to 0. So we'll add 12x to both sides and then subtract 3 on both sides, which would give us the equation 9x squared plus 12x minus 3 equals 0. So in this form, we can now recognize that a is equal to positive 9, b is equal to positive 12, and c is equal to negative 3. So we'll use these values to perform substitution into the quadratic formula. So we'll have x equals negative b, or negative 12, plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac, which would be 12 squared minus 4 times 9 times negative 3, all divided by 2 times a, or in this case 2 times 9. Notice how for this first step, we just performed the substitution. Now we'll begin to simplify. So now we'll have x equals negative 12 plus or minus the square root. 12 squared is 144. Then we have minus 4 times 9 times negative 3. That'll be minus negative 108, or plus 108, divided by 2 times 9, which is 18. So now we have x equals negative 12 plus or minus the square root of 144 plus 108 is equal to 252. And now for the next step, we want to simplify the square root of 252 by identifying all the perfect square factors of 252. To do this, we're going to find the prime factorization of 252. Well, 252 is equal to 2 times 126, which is equal to 2 times 63, which is equal to 9 times 7, and 9 is equal to 3 times 3. So the prime factorization would be 2 times 2 times 3 times 3 times 7. Every time we have two equal factors, the square root will simplify. This is a perfect square factor, and so is this. The square root of 2 times 2 is 2. The square root of 3 times 3 is 3. And we still have square root 7. So this simplifies to 6 square root 7. So now we have x equals negative 12 plus or minus 6 square root 7 all over 18. Now there's a couple ways of simplifying this, and we'll show both, but for the first method, we're going to break this up into two separate fractions since we're dividing by a binomial. This is the same as negative 12 over 18 plus or minus 6 square root 7 over 18. In this form, we'll simplify each fraction separately. The common factor of 6 in 12 and 18, there are 3 6s in 18 and 2 6s in 12. Again, we have a common factor of 6. There are 3 6s in 18 and 1 6 in 6. So our solutions are x equals negative 2/3 plus or minus, this would be square root 7 over 3. We have two solutions here. Both of these are in simplified form. One solution is negative 2/3 plus square root 7 over 3. The other solution is negative 2/3 minus square root 7 over 3. But let's go ahead and show the second method for simplifying our solutions. So let's go ahead and consider this form here. We need to be careful because it would be a mistake to just simplify the 12 and the 18 here. We cannot simplify across addition or subtraction. So if we look at the numerator, notice that 12 and 6 share a common factor of 6. So we could write this as x equals 6 times the quantity, negative 2 plus or minus square root 7. And then we know that 18 is equal to 6 times 3. Now because our factors are being multiplied, we can simplify this. 6 over 6 simplifies to 1. So our solution can also be expressed as x equals negative 2 plus or minus square root 7 all over the denominator of 3. So both of these solutions are equivalent, even though they are in a slightly different form. Okay, I hope you found this example helpful.